Welcome to my YouTube channel, philippospan. Weekly tips and tricks on how to work with Microsoft Office applications. Be wise and subscribe.
Today's video will be about Microsoft Office applications in general.
How to apply sensitivity labels to your files and email in Microsoft Office. In Microsoft Office applications, we can apply labels to our documents, spreadsheets, and presentations. These labels are named sensitivity labels, and for us to use this feature, we must have a Microsoft 365 subscription and for our administrators to have them set up. The names of these labels, the descriptions that we see when we hover over them, and for when to use each label will be customized by our organization, meaning our administrator. There are cases where our administrator may have not configured automatic labeling, but they may have configured our system to require a label on all of the Office files and emails. If labels are required, we will not be able to save our Word document, Excel spreadsheet, PowerPoint presentation, or even send an email without selecting a sensitivity label. From the Home tab of the ribbon, we locate the area at the far right, which is the area named Sensitivity. Once we select the Sensitivity command, the drop-down menu appears where we can select one of the following, which, as mentioned, is set up from our administrator. Personal, non-business data for personal use only. Public, business data that is specifically prepared and approved for public consumption. General, business data that is not intended for public consumption. Examples include a company internal telephone directory, organizational charts, internal standards, and most internal communication. Confidential, confidential data that requires protection, which allow all employees full permissions. Data owners can track and revoke content. Once selected, we have the option to select either one of the following. All employees, confidential data that requires protection, which allow all employees full permissions. Data owners can track and revoke content. Anyone, not protected. Data that does not require protection. Use this option with care and with appropriate business justification. Highly confidential. Once selected, we can select from one of the following. All employees. Highly confidential data that allows all employees view, edit, and reply permissions to this content. Data owners can track and revoke content. Anyone, not protected. Data that does not require protection. Use this option with care and with appropriate business justification. And privacy, Greek National ID card. Highly confidential and privacy. If we select either one of them, the permission dialog box appears where we can activate the checkbox at the right of the command. Restrict permission to this document. Once activated, then we can specify a user by email address or domain separated by semicolons or click the read or change buttons to select from the address book. If we select the read button, we can read this document but can't change, print, or copy content. If we select the change button, we can read, change, and copy content from this document but can't print it. Either we select read, either we select change, at the end we must press the OK button located at the bottom right corner for the adjustments to take place. As mentioned, sensitivity labels are set up from our administrator. So if we try to deselect a sensitivity label that has been applied to a file and try not to have one,
A Microsoft informational dialog box appears mentioning, "Your organization requires you to label this item." If we have applied a label and need to change it, an informational dialog box appears mentioning, "Your organization requires justification to change this label. Previous label no longer applies. Previous label was incorrect. Other, explain. Do not enter sensitive information." We just select what we want and press the change button. We can see the labels that are available and have been set up in Microsoft Excel. And in Microsoft PowerPoint. In a few words, sensitivity labels let us protect our organization data and we make sure that the user's efficiency and capability to cooperate isn't tampered.
Thank you for watching. If you liked what you saw in this video, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have any questions or suggestions, head down to the comment section and let me know. Be wise and subscribe.